Good morning, 10th standard students. Again, we are back with English. And in English, we are going to learn about the second unit which we have started. We have finished two lessons. Third lesson is connecting dots, but I'm not going to take today that connecting dots. I'm going to take the fourth lesson, that is something called pulley. And I hope so you understand what is pulley. How many of you have seen the well? And in the well, you can see there is something which is for the rod. You put the, what you call, the rope in that, and then leave the bucket inside, and then you pull. So the one which helps to pull the bucket up is called pulley. Same way for the flag, if you see, there is a, in between there is a small wheel where you put the rope into that, and then you leave the flag or you tie the flag. So that is something called pulley. The work of the pulley is to help something to pull up. It helps something to pull. That is just a what they call an instrument which helps for things to be pulled up. The same thing is something in this lesson, pulley, wherein God is trying to pull us up. Okay, He is trying to pull us up where we are fallen in sin, where we are gone into the bad things, and He wants us to bring us back to Him. God wants to bring us back to Him. So He is using this metaphor of pulley, wherein He used this pulley to pull us up. Okay, so that we will see in today's lesson, pulley, written by George Herbert. Okay, George Herbert was a Welsh poet. He was a priest by profession. That is why you have the spiritual connotation in that pulley. He wrote religious poems with a lot of imagery and conceits. The poem exhibits a strange but two-way relationship between God and His worshippers. Though He has bestowed His worshipper with all His blessings, somewhere He holds them up. Somewhere He holds them up with a pulley, drawn to be grateful to Him in all our endeavor. God gives so many precious gifts to the devotee, but at the same time, God also expects something in return. What does He expect? Why does He withhold? The pulley shows how God lifts man towards Himself with the pulley of restlessness. What is distinctly metaphysical about the poem is that a religious notion is conveyed through a secular scientific image. Okay, secular scientific image, that is pulley is used. When God at first made man, having a glass of blessing standing by, "Let us," said He, "pour on him all we can. Let the world's riches with which dispersed lie contract into a span." Means He gave us everything. He gave us, He told us, multiply, use the things. He poured on us all the talents, gifts and all. So strength first made a way, then beauty flowed, then wisdom, honor, pleasure. When almost all was out, God made a stay, perceiving that alone of all His treasures, rest in the bottom lay. Okay, He gave everything. He gave the strength, He gave the beauty, He gave wisdom, honor, pleasure. And everything, God made a stay, perceiving that alone of all His treasures, rest in the bottom lay. Okay, everything He gave. Noticing, becoming conscious of everything He gave. "For if I should," said He, "bestow the jewel also on my creature, he would adore my gifts instead of me." Okay, "and rest in nature, not the God of nature." So both should losers be. "Yet let him keep the rest, but keep them with repining restlessness. Let him be rich and weary, that at last, if goodness lead him not, yet weariness may toss him to my breast." George Herbert. He is the one who has written it. He gave everything. He told Lord, "If I give everything to this man, he may forget me. Instead of respecting me, he would respect the nature. He would not adore me, but he would adore the nature." So that way, how he saw that the man was rich and weary, and at last, if goodness let him not, yet weariness may toss him to my breast. Means weariness may bring him back. थैंक यू।